In this tutorial, you'll see how to configure JumpCloud's RADIUS as a service for your organization's wireless or VPN networks. To get started, log into the JumpCloud Admin Portal as well as your networking device's admin console. In JumpCloud, navigate to the menu and click User Authentication, then RADIUS. Here, you'll see a list of all of your RADIUS authentication endpoints configured in JumpCloud. To add a new RADIUS authentication endpoint, click on the green plus button in the top left. A new panel will appear allowing you to configure a new JumpCloud RADIUS authentication endpoint. You'll see three fields under this menu: server name, IP address, and pre-filled shared secret. For the server name, you can call this anything that makes sense in your organization, such as the office name and what type of network it may be. For example, Boulder Corporate Office Wifi or Boulder Corporate VPN. Next, configure the IP field with the external IP address of where your network device resides. This could also be the ISP's address assigned to you on the circuit that you're using for your office. Finally, the shared secret is pre-filled by JumpCloud. This field will be needed later when configuring your network device for RADIUS Auth with JumpCloud. Copy this for later. To bind user groups that you'd like to give access to this network device, navigate to the User Management section in the menu and click User Groups. All users within these bound user groups will have access to this network device via RADIUS, meaning that they can log into the Wi-Fi or VPN with their JumpCloud username and password. When enabling RADIUS on either your wireless or VPN access points, each manufacturer's UI and configurations might be different, so check with your manufacturer's documentation where to configure RADIUS authentication. That's it! Check out JumpCloud's knowledge base articles for more information about RADIUS authentication for Wi-Fi or VPN endpoints.